上中文投资网，一个赚钱的网站。
好的，那刚刚在结束和布兰特老师的话家常单元之后呢，我们现在马上来看是最精彩压轴单元 Warren 老师。Warren 老师呢，他第二度接受了币圈的第一播客 The Bad Crypto Podcast 的专访哦。这次他带着我们交易平台的 CEO Donna Myers 一起来接受这位非常有名的这个币圈两人组的播客。这个币圈呢 The Bad Crypto Podcast 非常有名，它可以说是币圈第一播客，拥有400万人次的下载量，同时富比士杂志还曾经介绍这个博客。这两位美国的新闻人跟名嘴呢，这次要和 Warren 老师谈谈我们未来整个的发展方向，特别是交易平台在7月4号即将上线，这个令人振奋的消息现在全币圈都知道了。
Turn the Wayback Machine back to episode number 63 of Bad Crypto Travis, and you'll recall that we had Warren Wang, the Chinese investors, ChineseFN.com on the show.
I do recall. That was a great episode. There's a lot of really interesting stuff going on. I think that was, we interviewed Warren shortly thereafter, after China had banned ICOs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it's time to catch up and meet one of his cohorts and discuss a new crypto exchange that they're going to be launching for non-US regions on the 4th of July, which I think is funny because, you know, the 4th of July is our Independence Day, but it's the only place that you won't be able to access ICO168.io. And with us, we have once again, Warren Wang and Don Myers. Gentlemen, welcome to Bad Crypto.
Hi, Joe and Travis.
Hello. Thank you very much.
Great to have you guys here again. Before we jump into the exchange, maybe you can give us, Warren, a quick update on what's happening on the other side of the world in cryptos in Asia.
Sure. I think China banned ICO on September 4th in 2017, and the U.S. regulatory is getting more compliance, more regulations on the ICO too. So we saw the ICO from last year, 20,000 all the way dropped to 6,400. And then right now trading around like 8,000. And we see a lot of limited ICO happening in the United States. So we think other Chinese investors, we believe we saw other great news is there's two sectors really making money. One is the exchange. Binance, they just been 7 months, but they already been profitability. Their profitability is more than on the top of 99.5% all the Chinese public trading company in China. And they beat Deutsche Bank, the profitability on the first quarter. They only have 200 employees, but Deutsche Bank have 100,000 employees. They've been over 100 years. So that's very profitable sectors. Other one, you can see Consensus. They have over 10,000 people purchase ticket, average 2,000 per, and they generate $200 million in 3 days just by ticket selling. So that's kind of business we want the public trading company CIX want to enter into. So we are going to launch the new ICO168.io in St. Vincent, and we are ready to go.
Now, I have a question around that. So for one, congratulations on the success you guys have been having over there. What is ICO168, and what does that number mean? I assume it's like a good luck number or something in Chinese?
Yeah, 168 always means in Chinese, it's all the way to the fortune. What it stands for is I think the new coins can be all the way to the fortune for the new digital world. So it's a lucky number. It's a God bless things in Chinese language.
Very nice. So what is ICO168? Are you creating a new exchange for Chinese-speaking people who are living in America, or is this a worldwide exchange? What exactly is going on with ICO168?
I think we will just tailor to non-US, non-Canadian investors. non-Chinese investor in mainland China, which because three countries is basically banning the people trade cryptocurrency. So we're targeting overseas Chinese, for example, Singapore, Australia, maybe Europe, for all the Chinese around the world, non-overseas Chinese who like to trade cryptocurrency, who love to get an education, because all secret source is more focused on education, invest tools, and platform. So put everybody into the trading platform with the knowledge, with the experience, with the information speed, with the platform altogether. Not just giving them platform, let them trading, because we want to give people more education, make their trading life longer. That's all goals.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's interesting, this business, since ICOs have slowed, it's a picks and shovels business, and people are always going to need exchanges. Now, we see some of these exchanges having their own coin, their own ICO, like Binance and KuCoin. Are you guys doing something similar, having an ICO around ICO 168?
Not yet. Maybe down the road in the future. But I think definitely in the United States, we will issue security token instead of ICO. So it mean can be a STO then ICO. I think your guys are very knowledgeable on the ICO world. So we will issue the Regulation D down the road to accredit investor private sales instead of ICO cross sales in the United States. But we might issue the Reg S to non-US territory. You know, but it's still, you know, we don't official. There's no official news yet for this cross sales.
All right, now your website. One thing that you're talking about is some different tradable currencies. You're going to be able to have some trading pairs with Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin. Is NEO, which NEO is, you know, the Chinese Ethereum, is that something you guys are going to have as a tradable pair as well down the road?
I think. We will consult our tech teams, because if they are ERC-20, it might be very easy. It take a little while to have a NEO wallet, but you know, if the people only want to trade NEO, it can be done in a day. So we possibly after 4th of July we will launch another 20 different currency pair.
ChineseFN.com 中文投资网，一个赚钱的网站。好的，广告回来，继续是 CIX 每周华尔街比特币千万富翁的单元，我是主持人 Nanel， 在我旁边的是布兰特老师。
大家好。
那我们刚刚上面节目提到，我们比特币大家谈，布兰特老师一直跟大家说，这个东西不是泡沫，加密货币是未来的一个趋势，从20000跌到了6000，现在大家还在等，现在目前是7000。
嗯。
那我们一直说比特币还会再上去，那布兰特老师，我这个小韭菜等的有点急了，跟我说什么时候会上去吧。
这个单纯的从技术图形来看呢，确实很弱的啊。我们看最近的这个技术图形上，可能说的比较专业，就是上涨的时候都是缩量，但是下跌的时候都是放量。这是在技术形态当中比较利空的一个走势。但是呢，我把这个图形调出来，它和四月份今年要上涨的那个初期的时候啊，其实走势是非常非常雷同的。四月份的那个走势呢，就在突然毫无征兆的情况下出现了一个大幅度的上涨。那么我们不知道这一次是不是也会突然上涨，所以还是给大家一个建议，就是你要有耐心，你要静静的去持有。它会在毫无征兆的情况下突然呢出现一个暴力的拉升，那给大家一个非常非常利好的一个信号，就是全美最大的一个币币交易平台，我们知道全美最大的这个数字货币平台是 Coinbase 第二大的这个币币交易平台呢是 Bittrex。那要你采访过他的 CEO 他们呢最近开启了一个新的业务，就是他们和 Signature Bank 这家银行去签署了一个协议，将会 Signature Bank 呢将会为 Bittrex 去提供法币购买比特币的这个功能。法币它会有三个这个货币，法币 US 那个比特币 USDT 还有初链这几个，这三个币种是可以直接用法币去购买的，这是一个非常大的新闻。因为在美国大家都知道监管是非常严重的，所以才有很多的这个交易所都是在做币币交易。但是如果这个哪一个银行开始与交易所去做了一个数字货币这个法币的买卖的话，这代表监管的一个放松，这也代表银行们他们 抛开自己的名誉，抛开自己的这个风险体控，愿意去跟你去合作，这是他们对市场进一步的一个入场，所以这是一个非常非常利好的一个信号。
是，所以整个现在银行的氛围从抵触到现在开始拥抱这个加密货币市场，我们根本说这个大趋势是抵挡不住的。
对，
是
抵挡不住。
那现在温老师呢，一直都是站在趋势的最前端，他希望能够让更多的投资朋友进一步来了解，完整的认识这个领域，这个我们未来的这个世界哦。北加的这个讲座在很多我们北加州硅谷还有旧金山的朋友千呼万唤之下，汪老师这次终于又要带队我们前往北加了。
嗯，
是。
这一次呢阵容也比较多，
超级多，
超级多。对，我们公司的整个一个团队差不多就基本上要包机过去了。
是是，我房间订到手软，大概我们大概去了20个人吧。
对，差不多20个人。那我们这一次去呢，一共会有5位分析师跟大家去讲。那首先呢，我会第一个讲我会跟大家去介绍一下 NewCoins 168最新的一个平台。我们是集资讯、信息、交易、教育为一体的一个多样化的一个平台。那 Kingsley 老师呢也会跟大家分享一下最近币圈的一些动态然后最后是 Preston 老师跟大家讲一下 ICO， 这个是整个我们数字货币围绕着 NewCoins 168的。那同时呢，现在 NewCoins 168还全新打造了一个新的交易平台。这个交易平台将会在7月5号上线，但是首先是不对美国用户开放的。这个我们 NewCoins 168旗下的这个交易平台呢，会有我们的 CEO Don 他会出来跟大家去见面，
是，也是刚刚我们上半节目前面，
对对对，
待会节目下面要为大家介绍这个 Don 接受专访，他就提到这一块。
是的，是的，他会跟大家介绍中文投资网这个交易平台的这方面的业务到底怎么样。那最后就是大家期待的温润老师会亚洲登场，跟大家去分享之前、今后、未来数字货币一个大的一个趋势、宏观的一个发展。
是，所以当天呢，老师们都会在现场，有什么问题都可以亲自的问老师，得到第一手的观点还有交流。或是 Brun 老师这边的投资的这个组合怎么配置呢？如果当天有加入我们的这个朋友呢，相信 Brun 老师也会很海派的跟大家分享一下。所以呢，大家千万不要忘记，就是最重要跟大家讲时间地点，在我们硅谷还有旧金山。硅谷是在星期6的晚上6点钟，因为实在是房间完全订不到，哎，我怎么台湾国语，房间完全订不到，所以星期6晚上的6点钟，然后在旧金山是星期天的下午1点半，所以大家千万一定要来，现在还可以报名，我们网站上可以报名，另外微信还有电话都可以报名。想看到 Brun 老师本人，千万不要错过这个周末，6月2号、3号，我们都在北加州。
在经历了本周的 GDP 和非农数据轰炸后，美股市场下周可以给投资者稍许的喘息时间，至少在经济数据上不再那么繁忙。值得关注的数据只有周一上午10点的4月工厂订单数据，周二上午10点的 ISM 服务业指数，以及周三上午8点半公布的4月贸易账。财报季基本上已经结束，下周唯一值得关注的财报或许是周二盘后的中概股 YY 的财报。在经济数据和财报不多的情况下，下周主要还是关注消息面的新闻。特朗普和金正恩会面一波三折，但是仍然预计在6月12日在新加坡举行。当然，每一天都有可能发生变动，每一天的变动都有可能影响市场。此外，意大利那边的威胁已经减小，两党就内阁组成已经妥协，应该不会进一步引发动乱。那么以上就是下周的美股预告，我是 Laura， 我们下周再见。